I thought they were not going to use that flashlight. I don't want to be seen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But anyway, we are the children of the light. Hallelujah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
I would like to appreciate again God in this place. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm not going to spend much of your time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I know we are in darkness, but we are the children of the light. Hallelujah.
Yes.
But we are going to just speak a little bit and then we go and pray and then we go home. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Isn't that we are home away from home? Hallelujah.
Oh.
Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus.
Yeah.
Let us open in the book of Haggai, chapter number 2, verse number 7.
Haggai chapter 2, verse 7. And I will shake all nations, and the desire of all nations shall come, and I will fill this house with glory, saith the Lord of hosts.
Amen. Amen. Read also number 6.
Verse 6. For thus says the Lord of hosts, yet once it is a little while, and I will shake the heavens, and the earth, and the sea, and the dry land.
Amen. Read it again, man of God.
For thus says the Lord of hosts, yet once it is a little while.
He says, yet once it is a little while. Okay.
And I will shake the heavens.
He says, I will shake the heavens.
And the earth.
And the earth.
And the sea.
And the sea.
And the dry land.
And the dry land. Continue.
And I will shake all nations.
Amen.
And the desire of all nations shall come. And I will fill this house with glory, saith the Lord of hosts.
And I will fill this house with glory, says the Lord of hosts. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know I preach differently. Hallelujah. Don't be surprised. Hallelujah. We are not the same, but we are the same body. Hallelujah. If you are the leg, I'm not the leg, I'm the head. Hallelujah. At least you are laughing. Hallelujah. Men of God, pray for the word.
Gracious God, we thank you for the reading of your word. Bless each and every ear that just heard the reading of your word, and we thank you for your servant that will be using my God to communicate your word. We thank you to the glory of Christ in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The EOC, please, this time don't rob me with time. Please, I started very late, you say it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They've already written a notice. Okay. Let us bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Where we have read in the book of Haggai, chapter number 2. We are very familiar with the situation that Judah was going through. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It was the time whereby Cyrus the king, he released the children of Israel or of Judah, hallelujah, to go and rebuild the temple of the Lord according to the promise that he has declared upon Jeremiah, hallelujah, that after the 70 years of desolation or of captivity, they will go back and be released from the land of Babylonia, hallelujah, and then they will go back and rebuild the temple of the Lord because it was destroyed. Hallelujah. And then now it was when they arrived in the land of Judah, these people, they were so relaxed. They were delivered, isn't it that? Hallelujah. They were delivered from the power of the enemy. They were delivered from the hand of the captive. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then when they arrived in the land of Judah, they started not doing the purpose of God. They diverted and they shifted their focus from the main purpose why they were released in the land of Babylonia. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Then they arrived, and then in verse in chapter number 1, we hear very well God saying, is it time for you to leave
in sealed houses, in expensive houses. Why my house is the house of prayer, the house of the Lord, lie in waste? Because they have shifted from their purpose. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This church has become a place whereby the house of God was not taken care of. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This church became ignorant of their purpose. But I pray and I believe that we are not such a church. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That our purpose and our mission in Christ, we are still holding it with our hands. Hallelujah. Because the Bible says, if the Son of Man is to come, will he find faith on earth? Hey, Shantana Parahaya. You see, Kaya, Leka, Sofaya. When the gospel was preached to you, the first thing that came to you was faith. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then that is why the Bible says, if the Son of Man comes to earth, will he still find faith in the church? My, Leko, Zaya. Okay, here are the children of Israel. They arrived in the land that God gave them. Okay, let us pass chapter number 1. This chapter number 2, where we have read. Now God was encouraging or exalting the children of Judah. It was kind of a revival because they were told that go and rebuild the temple of God. Hallelujah. But when they arrived, they relaxed. Hallelujah. And then in chapter number 2, he says, and God stirred up the spirit of Zerubbabel. Zerubbabel, by that time, he was the governor of the land. And he was the son of Shealtiel. And he speaks about Joshua, the son of Joseph. Hallelujah, the high priest. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He also speaks about the remnant that came with them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, it's the spirit of God stirred up their spirit. I pray that God will stir up our spirit.
Yes.
Because there is no revival without the Spirit of God.
Yes.
If you take the first revival that happened in the day of Pentecost, it was by the Spirit of God.
Yes.
If you take the revival in Azusa Street, it was by the Spirit of God.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I pray that God will stir up your spirit today.
Yes.
Oh yes. And then the Bible continues to tell us. He says, it is a little while. In a little while. Yet once again, it is a little while. I don't know, but my little while has come. I don't know about your little while. The Bible says the time is coming. Indeed it is. When the true worshippers shall worship the Lord in truth and in spirit.
Oh, yes.
But I understand, you will confess with me, that in the last day, the spirit of the Lord shall be poured upon all flesh.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Upon all flesh. Your sons and daughters shall prophesy. And then I believe that my little while has come.
Oh, yes.
For the spirit to take over and the revival shall begin. Not anywhere else, but in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. And then now God says, in a little while, I will shake the heavens and the earth, the dry land and the sea. I will shake all nations, and every nation desires shall be in this house, and my glory will be in this house. That when revival comes in,
amen.
When the glory of God is in the house of God.
Oh, yes.
What is the house of God? You are the house of God.
Amen.
You are the temple of God.
Amen.
You are the carrier of the presence of God.
Amen.
He says, when he,
yes,
in the book of John chapter number 16, verse number 13, he says, when he, the spirit of truth comes,
yes,
which means God also comes.
Yes,
I don't know where you'll be coming from.
Yes,
But he also comes, and I hear him saying it again in the book of Isaiah chapter number 59, verse number 19. He says, "And my glory and my name will be feared from the west, and my glory from the rising of the sun. And when the enemy shall come," which means also the enemy shall come. I don't know which message you will believe, but I believe that God will also come. He says, "When the enemy shall come in like a flood, but the Spirit of the Lord shall raise the standard against you." I don't know about you, my sister, my brother, which message are you believing? But I believe that the enemy shall come. Surely shall come. But when he comes, he shall find me aligned with the Spirit of God. Because when he comes, the Spirit shall keep the standard against the enemy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It means now, when you are not connected, when the Spirit of God, when the Spirit of God, if you are not aligned with the kingdom of God, it means that when the enemy comes, he will take you, because he will come, he will be coming like a flood. We understand that when the floods they come to destroy, to take away without permission, that is killing, kill those who cannot walk. Hallelujah. 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 I pray that God will help us as a church to stay. He says in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter number 9, verse number 8, he says, "Let your garment be always white, and your head be always having an ointment." Hallelujah. It symbolizes that you must be always holy. Holy on Monday, holy on Tuesday, and Sunday. He says, "Be we holy, for he who called you is holy." Hallelujah. He says, "Follow peace with all men and holiness, for without which no man shall see the Lord." In other words, now when we are holy, we are like God. And if you are still playing hard and seek, who is your father? Yes. It is a little while that I will shake the heavens and the earth, the land and the dry sea, and the sea. All nations' desires shall be in this house, and my glory will be in this house. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Our God shall come. Help me today or tonight to say to you, your little while has come. Your little while has come. Because the Spirit of the Lord is upon you. It is the time for the children of God to manifest.
Yes.
The nature has been waiting. The creation has been waiting. What is the creation? It is the thing that God created. One of them is human beings who are not saved. They've been waiting for the manifestation of the children of God. He says, "Go ye and preach this gospel to every creature." The creation is the creature. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He's waiting for you to manifest. When you start manifesting, I realize something. The Bible says, in the version book of Isaiah 59, verse number 12, it says, "And the Redeemer shall come unto Zion, and unto them that turn from their transgression, saith the Lord." And then he says, "And as for me," verse number 21, it says, "As for me, I will make a covenant with them, and my Spirit which is upon thee, and the words that I have put in thy mouth." And he says, "They shall not depart from thy mouth, nor in your city's mouth, nor in your city's mouth, saith the Lord, from now and forever." Verse number, chapter number 60. He says, "Arise, shine, for thy light has come. For the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee." See, since God has come. Now it is your time to arise.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Since God has come,
amen.
Your little wife has come.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Those who have been looking down on you, Kai, they will see you moving.
Yes.
They will see you moving. Because they are doing it. They will see you moving. Hallelujah.
Yes.
They will see you moving.
Yeah.
At one in Tatala.
Hey.
One in Begana.
Hey.
One in Susana.
Hey.
One in Begana.
Hey.
They will see you moving. You see, these songs, we sing them.
Yeah.
But let them manifest.
Yes.
Let them manifest. And let them. Let the creation see you manifesting as a child of God.
Yes.
And let God receive the glory.
Yes.
You see, God said, Jesus says, and they shall see your works, and they shall glorify
yes.
God.
Yes.
Which works have you done? Which make the world glorify God?
Jesus.
Your little while has come. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
May the Spirit of the Lord help us.
Yes.
May the Spirit of the Father help us.
Yes.
Oh, yes. Because in verse number 2 of Isaiah 60, he says, and darkness shall cover the earth. And he says, and gross darkness shall cover the people. But the Lord will rise upon thee and to shine. And he says, and the Gentiles will come. And they will come. You see, Gentiles are people who are not born again. Non-believers, they will come. Because they see that there is light in you. Because one of the steps that you have made is to arise. As a child of God. Because your little while has come. Man, that I will have so fire had done. My message was not that long. But until here, I am saying your little while has come.
Yeah.
Your little while has come.
Yeah.
It is your time to manifest as a child of God.
Yeah.
It is your time to show the world that there is God in heaven.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. How should we manifest it when we are still living like this? When you are still practicing the cultures of this world,
yeah.
When you are still practicing in order to be favored by men,
yeah.
How should we manifest when we are still conforming to the standard of this world?
Yeah.
Hallelujah!
Yeah.
Hallelujah! How should we manifest when we speak there is no difference like a heaven? Maya, shekete. Because out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. So we need to manifest as the children of God by eating the word of God.
Yes. Yes,
because
yes,
the word of God cannot jump out of the Bible and come to your mind, to your heart.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
We need the word of God.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
See, I have a problem, man.
Okay.
I have a problem with people who are not reading the word of God. You see, since you received faith by word, how can you maintain your faith without reading the word? Which source are you using to maintain your faith? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I pray that God will raise people.
Oh,
Maya, Messiah, even every one of you. You see, be crazy for Jesus.
Yes.
Be crazy that you are born again.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And when the world see you as a crazy person.
Yes.
The Bible says, woe unto us when everyone loves us.
Yes.
The reason why everyone loves us is because we conform to their standard.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us just arise. Let us just stand up. See, the Bible says, in the last days, I will pour out of my spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and daughters will prophesy. Which means God is going to give us of his own. And he says, and he will show you things to come. In verse number 13 of chapter number 16 of John. And he will show you things to come. And whatsoever
he says, yes, he will tell you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because he will not be speaking for himself. Hallelujah. And the Bible says in the book of Psalm, chapter number 50. Verse number 3. It says, our God shall come. He shall not just come, but a devouring fire before him, and a tempest round about him. Which means God, when he comes into a place, I understand God is in this place. But there are times and seasons where God needs people to be perceptive of his movement. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, there are seasons and times when we need to be very, very alert. Or let me say this thing. We need always to be very alert of the move of the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Because sometimes we may say, they are no longer intercessors. But what are we doing as a church? It's because we are not alert of what is happening. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We need to always be aligned with the Spirit of God. Let us pray that God, that in our meetings, let them not be just normal. In our daily services, let them not just be normal. God, may you raise the standard of our ministers from the worshippers to the ushers. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because we understand one thing, that when a standard is raised, nothing can do us any harm. But we need to be aligned with the Spirit of God, because he is the only one that can raise our standard. Hallelujah. So let us pray that God, let our meetings not just be normal. Let there be a change in our meetings. Let us pray that God, he may revive us. In the book of Psalm, I think it's chapter number 90. He says, revive us, O God, so that we can call upon thee. So we understand something, that without a revival, how can we call upon God? Maya delibe heseke deliba. Just begin praying wherever you are, that God may declare a change even in our meetings. In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. If there is anyone here, you have never confessed Jesus Christ.